DM Science and Plants World presents about the simple fruit, in that we are going to see about the fleshy fruit. General definition: fruit is a product of pollination and fertilization. Pollination is a process of transfer of pollen grains, that is male gamete, to the stigma, that is the region of female flower where the pollen grains used to stick on it. After the pollination of process, the fertilization process takes place, in which the male and female gamete used to fuse together, which results in the formation of fruits and seed. A fruit may also be defined in a way as an edible product of entire gynoecium. Gynoecium is also called a pistil or carpel, which encloses the parts like stigma, style, ovary, ovary wall, ovule, and all. And in some fruits, along with gynoecium, the floral parts like sepals and petals used to form the fruit, which is sweet, juicy, or fleshy, colored, aromatic, and it also encloses the seed. However, the fruit corely defined as fertilized and ripened ovary. Pomology is a branch of horticulture that deals with the fruits and their cultivation. Structure of fruit. Fruit has the fruit wall, which is called as pericarp. The pericarp is differentiated into outer epicarp, middle mesocarp, and inner endocarp. The inner part of the fruit is occupied by the seeds. In the picture, you could find the epicarp, mesocarp, and endocarp. Endocarp present in the inner region and the mesocarp present in between the endocarp and epicarp. Epicarp is the outer covering of the fruit. Simple fruit. The simple fruits are the fruits that derive from the single ovary of the flower. Example, mango, tomato. Simple fruits are classified into two types of fruits. They are the fleshy fruits and dry fruits based on the nature of pericarp. In this video, we are going to see about the fleshy fruit. As I said before, the fruits are derived from the single pistil, that means from the single gynoecium, that means from the single ovary, where the pericarp is fleshy, succulent, and differentiated into three layers, that is epicarp, mesocarp, and endocarp, as you found in the picture. And the fleshy fruits are categorized into following types. They are the berry, drup, pepo, hesperidium, pome, and blastar. First, we are going to see about the berry. Berry are the fruits that developed from the bicarpellary or multicarpellary syncarpous ovary. Bicarpellary means the carpel is two. Multicarpellary means the carpel number is many. In the picture of tomato, that is from the cross section of tomato, you can find the two carpel region, and that is this one is one carpel region and this one is another carpel region. So altogether it is called bicarpellary. In some tomato fruits you can find the tricarpellary ovary also. Syncarpus is a condition in which the carpel is more than one and those carpels are fused together. Here you can find the two carpels and this two carpel region are fused. So this condition is referred as syncarpous ovary. Here the epicarp is thin. Here you can find the thin epicarp, and the mesocarp and endocarp is undifferentiated and forms the pulpy region in which the seed is embedded. Example, tomato, palm, grapes, and brinjal. Second one is the drup of fleshy fruit. Here the fruit is developed from the monocarpellary superior ovary, that is superior ovary. Monocarpellary means it contains only one carpel region. As you found in tomato, you can find the two carpel region. In case of monocarpellary means you can find only one ovary in which only one ovule is present. Superior ovary means the ovary is attached to the receptacle, which is above the region of or attachment of floral parts. The sepals and petals are attached below the attachment of ovary. That condition is referred as superior ovary. It also contains only one seed because monocarpellary is a condition where the ovary contains only one ovule. So ovule going to become a seed which forms the one seed. So the monocarpellary fruits forms only one seed. The pericarp is differentiated into outer skinny epicarp. In the picture of coconut, you can find the epicarp which is skinny and the fleshy and pulpy mesocarp, the endocarp which is hard and stony, which is surrounded by in the seed. In the picture, you can find the skinny epicarp and this is the mesocarp which is pulpy and fleshy, and followed by it you can find the stony region that is called endocarp, in which the seed is enclosed. Third one is pepo. Here the fruit is developed from the tricarpellary inferior ovary. Here you can find the tricarpal region 1, 2 and 3. This condition is called as tricarpellary ovary, and inferior ovary means this is the condition in which the placement or attachment of ovary found below the floral parts to the receptacle. In a flower, the floral parts are attached above the attachment of ovary. That condition is referred as inferior ovary. Pericarp here turns into leathery condition which encloses the fleshy mesocarp and smooth endocarp. While eating cucumber, you can just have a look on it to find the leathery epicarp and fleshy and smooth mesocarp and endocarp which encloses the seed. Example for pepo is cucumber, watermelon, bottle gourd and pumpkin. Fourth one is Hesperidium. Example orange and lemon. Look at this picture. You can find the multicarpellary ovary and multilocular syncarpous superior ovary. Superior ovary means is the condition that is the placement of ovary is above the floral parts. Syncarpous is means the carpels are fused together. Multilocular means it contains many chambers. Multicarpellary means the presence of carpel is many. Here the fruit wall is differentiated into leathery epicarp with oil glands, and the middle carp is fibrous, where you can find the thread-like structures, and the endocarp forms the distinct chambers contain juicy hairs. In the picture of orange, you can find the epicarp and mesocarp which forms the skin, and the endocarp forms the pulpy region. Pome. This is a fruit which developed from the multicarpellary syncarpous inferior ovary. As I said before, syncarpous is a condition of fusion of carpels. Inferior ovary means the ovary placed below the attachment of floral parts. Here the receptacle also developed along with ovary and forms the fleshy fruit. In this, epicarp is thin skin-like structure and the endocarp is cartilaginous. Here, this is the receptacle which forms the fruit which is enclosed by the pulpy region. Example, apple and pear. Blastar. This is the indigestant fruit. That means the fruit won't separate or divide after the maturation. So, the seeds won't dispersed in air or anything. And it formed from the multicarpellary, multilocular, inferior ovary, where the epicarp, that is pericarp, is tough and leathery. The seeds are attached irregularly to the testa and forms the edible portion. Example, pomegranate. Thank you so much for watching.